I wish to establish peace and order, and will do just that. You cannot stop me.
It's over.
Well done. Nice work.
Here I go. Sage lightning strike.
I'll take this. I'll put an end to all your antics.
Water, lightning, wind, fire. Stay strong now.
You won't overcome this. Now you'll know how power is.
Lend me your strength, brother!
Just this one time.
Let's begin. Time has come.
Hey everyone, it's me, David, with Bandai Namco, and I'm here with Afro Senju himself.
Yoi, thank you for having me.
Today we're going to be talking about Naruto Cross Boruto Ultimate Ninja Storm Connections. So, as we all know, there's been a recent update with it. We've gotten the first DLC character, Hagoromo Otsutsuki, and there's been some updates to multiplayer, so now we have custom matchmaking. You can do league and tournament modes. Yeah. I think it's been a pretty exciting update. You've gotten to play it a little bit with Hagoromo. Mm-hmm. How do you feel about him so far?
I think he's an interesting character. I mean, when you consider the meta of who's at the top, I think it's really cool how he just fits right in there, you know what I'm saying? I feel like as a support, he's really good. He has one really good support attack. And as a main character, I feel like his combos are very strong. He has like one weakness, but we'll get into it as we go further, you know?
Okay. So Afro, I think you've got some history with the Storm series,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Okay.
The core memory I remember the most, that's a redundant sentence, but I remember in Storm 2, I didn't have any internet, anything like that. I used to go to the library to watch the trailers for that game. And from there, I think the one I got into the most was Naruto Storm Generations. Even from my channel itself, like I made my channel initially for like my little clan on Storm 3. And just from there, I've always kept Naruto somewhere in my life. Storm specifically,
yeah.
I just loved it. I don't know. I think it's being able to talk trash to people who have something in common with you with the show. It's just, you know what I'm saying? This is what it feels like, you know?
It's the Nakama, it's the friendship.
The Nakama. The Nakama you made along the way.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
That's all it is. We're gonna jump into it, see some of the practice mode. You can tell me a little bit about Hagoromo and we'll see how he plays.
Okay. Let me show off real quick, I guess.
All right.
Awesome.
Okay, so we've got Hagoromo up here. And I guess first off, who is Hagoromo in the world of Naruto?
Yes, Hagoromo is the Sage of Six Paths. He is pretty much minus Kaguya, the progenitor of Chakra and the ninja world that you see today. You see how Naruto's copying his fit? Mm-hmm. It's just like that. He has it like that.
He's
so
got that
pretty good character.
Energy.
Pretty lore heavy character. And yeah, do you want me to begin to show the character? I'm gonna do it.
Yeah, let's see.
let's do the basic stuff. This is a neutral combo. Pretty nice, very flashy. His flashiness actually comes into one of his strengths as his character. Not many characters can just produce a whole AMV in their moveset like this. So you can imagine how hard it might be to be able to fight someone who can do this. You feel like you're taking a lot of damage when you're really not. It's regular scale damage like everybody else. So you might tend to, you know, sub a little bit more things because of that.
He scares you.
Yes.
Right? He scares you into it.
He does. So you just saw his neutral down and up combo. This is his air combo, which is really nice. That right there, I sub it every time. I feel like that is an ultimate and I'm in danger. His grab is one of the best things in his kit because from right here, bro, look at it. It's disgusting.
Oh.
It creeps up, it's long range. It's because it creeps up is what makes it really good. So you can combo it like this. You know, it's ridiculous. There's so many things you can do with it.
Like, if there's a lot of stuff going on screen, it's going to be hard to see that's coming, right?
You could just sneak it, grab their leg, and honestly...
Ooh, it's so sneaky.
It is. It's crazy. It's the best thing about them. Not the best, but one of the best things about them that I love and hate to play against. But, yeah,
Would you say that there's other players that have similar kind of hidden grabs like that in the series?
If I could, yeah. I would say there's a lot of characters that have grabs that you can fit into combos, I would say, very easily. Like Shikamaru has a grab that you look at it, you would think it's part of his combo if you cancel it, right? A few other grabs, I can't think of top. Oh, Sasuke, he does like a little lightning around the field. Yeah. Uh-huh. That's a really good grab. And if I'm not mistaken, I think the Sage of Six Paths Obito has a cool one as well too. There's many more, but that's the top of my head. Mm-hmm. But for his jutsus, this is the Lightning Jutsu Triangle Circle, which best jutsu, one of the best in the game, I'd even say. And his second one, Triangle Square, which is like pew pews, best way to put it. And I'll think of a bunch
jutsu
of Rasengans.
And pew pews?
Yeah. Okay. Actually, very good way to put that. Uh-huh. And besides that, you have his ultimate. But I do want to touch on this real quick. This right here is this character's legacy, bro. This can hit you in the air. This can, bro, even as support, which we'll see in like 5 seconds. Even as support, it can knock out like your whole team if you do it at the right time. It's amazing, as I didn't do the right thing. But you get what I'm trying to say, when I can show it. His support's really amazing because of just how the utility it has, even the guard pressure, when you guard it, it just eats at your guard. It's crazy, and you can even combo off of it too. So if I just do this, I could just still attack you while it just hits you. And the stun is ridiculous as well. You have to like sub, I think, 2 times to properly defend it. But yeah.
He seems like a powerful character, right?
Yes.
So
yes.
What would you say are his downsides for how he plays?
His downsides, I would say, is definitely his speed. Mm-hmm. This right here, there's a lot of characters that can beat that if we're like face to face like this. If you rush him down and you're really good at dashing, you can probably overpower this character. But because his combos are so flashy, once you get him going, you know, the rush down is a little bit harder because it's kind of hard to see. But in the right hands, you can really get past this one weakness he has, I would say. His grab as well, I would say, suffers the same weakness because it is slow. But you know, when you're right in someone's face, then again, you could also like counter that. Or if you do it when there's ways to use this to where it's a strength, but if you're using the character just vanilla, there's weaknesses that it's just gonna have. But the ultimate, can I show that? I don't think I showed that yet.
Let's see it.
The ultimate, I think, itself is really cool. I like it. Very flashy. But with his ultimate also comes one of his biggest strengths that I don't think any other character in this game has. After the little AMV, got the destruction. Super Chidori dang there. Okay. Now, I'm sure a lot of you guys are aware of combo cancels. Basically, a combo cancel is where you can stop and then do the jutsu. Mm-hmm. With Hagoromo, he is the only character in this game that you can combo cancel. Combo cancel off of any hit of his combo. The first one, if I could do it. I don't think I've ever tried to do off the first hit. Okay, we're close. But yeah, okay. You get the gist. I could do like close to finishing the combo. It works. I could do a middle of like the down combo right here. It works. No character in this game has that versatility to just combo off of anything like that. And even his jutsu itself, his ultimate itself, it shoots it out. So you can kind of use this in between like a support. So if I called out Ashura and then use this, he's caught in the stun and you could just get it off. It's amazing. He has a lot of utility when it comes to that. And for that reason, I would say he's like he can be around like an A. If we're going from a scale from S to D, I don't think no character is a D tier, but he's mid A for sure. Okay. Could be high S if depending who picks him up and who like really puts in work with him.
What kind of assist do you think would work really well with him? I see that you have Indra and Asher here right now, so you have like the Otsutsuki kind of family clan going on.
Yeah, this team is probably one of his best teams too, and it's a canon team. Yeah. But I would say like Ashura and this guy work so good together, it's insane. Ashura is probably one of the best supports in the game, and I could even give the same token to Hagoromo's Lightning as well. Mm-hmm. But off of both of these characters, like you can just do so many combos off of it. Like if I just did that I switched it. But you get the gist. If I did that ball and I just comboed in Lightning, or if I comboed in an alt, and if I was close enough, I could have still continued the combo. There's just so much that you can do with him. I think for characters that I think can also work with him too, Daryu, if I'm saying his name right, he's really good. Tamari's also really good. I can even say like Rock Lee, any character that can hold them in a combo, yeah. I think Hagoromo best excels in because he can take advantage of just starting his combos that add so much pressure once he gets going. That's the best way I describe his character. Once he gets going, it's just kind of hard to stop it, stop his momentum.
Like there's some lead up time to his attacks, right?
Yes.
So if you're able to, like, I guess a good counter for him would be someone that can just like rush down, like really speedy to like stop him from getting started.
Mm-hmm. Like I would say some of the best characters in this game, I would say Hanzo, the first Sarada, and maybe even Kiba. Mm-hmm. I would say all of their first hits definitely are beating Hagoromo's first hit, but I still think he has enough in his kit to be able to fight what make those characters strong.
Okay. So upsides, you would say he, once he gets started, it's hard to get out of his attacks.
Yes.
Downsides, not as speedy as other characters, right?
Mm-hmm.
But those combos, like those assist setups that you have, and that grab, nasty.
Yeah, the grab is crazy.
That one's pretty intense too, right? Because once it hits, there's like a little delay of the lightning, right?
Yeah, and you can just combo Ashura. Like there's so much you can do off of the lightning, which is why I think even like other characters too, like if you use like Shino or Hanzo to give, like put him in the lead, so you give Hagoromo a poison tag, there's just so much more you're then able to do upon them. He's already draining damage. You're pushing him back as well in the combos. You can just play a different game to kind of more so win off of poison damage and, you know, middle of his combos than just, you know, his basic stuff. There's just a lot of things you can do with this character to mix it up. Really nice. Really nice.
Those combos are pretty intense.
Yeah, and I think it's cool too because it's really true to the character. Like, this is the first game where we see Hagoromo do anything.
Yeah.
And I feel like they did a good job just making him feel strong. Mm-hmm. I think him and Kaguya, there might be another I can't think of the top of my head, but like, they actually feel like you're fighting a boss.
Yeah.
Like, I was fighting my friend against this character when it first came out, and I literally felt like I was fighting a boss fight. Someone who knew what he's doing is just ridiculous. Like, same with the Awakening as well, too. I don't know if I can just touch on that, too.
Oh, yeah, let's see it.
Okay. Hold on, let me... You would think it's my first time doing this. Oh, there we go. Chakra. Yeah, his Awakening is crazy, too, because what I was saying with the boss battle concept, it really just feels like it. Like, he can just do... So that's his right option.
I mean, he's
option.
Got, like, every element at his disposal, right?
Yeah, it's ridiculous. And even his jutsus as well. That's the left option. This is the top, which is, like, a vortex where you're at. Like, if I go to a distance and do triangle square, let me do it again. But if I go from distance to triangle square, it's like the pressure that adds is insane. And it's just, he does a move that only a few people can do in the series so casually. Like, what is this?
That little teleport.
And who then, gave bro they, his license?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And then he does a sweep, which That's is very wild. Similar to like Obito's sweep that he does in the boss fights and this stuff.
So it's would you really say cool. He plays a little differently when he's in his awakening form?
Yes.
Awakening mode?
Yes. I would say his awakening actions is what makes him different. Mm-hmm. His actual combos are the same, but with all of his combos giving stun, you could just do, okay, maybe not that one. There's a few you got to experiment with.
Oh, that one shot behind him a little bit.
Right? Yeah, it shoot projectiles at where you're at, but you can just combo it in. Because every combo has a stun that he does off of it. So you can just kind of play a different game. Like if I were to do, let's say, if I combo it into Planetary Devastation, I think that can work. Hold on. So I do this. Yeah, like there's just so many options you can do just because every combo adds stun. He's a strong character for that. Very strong.
I mean, that's a good way to get back into the fight, right? Because you get some distance too from the character.
Yeah, like you're able to play zoning really well, and you could go back in and, you know, you can mix it up, be bilingual with it, get like close combat. Like it's very good options for sure. And the grab, my gosh. I like the details too, because if you really look, like he turns all of his the balls in his back into the grab, which is really sick.
Oh.
Really small detail, but it's really cool to add that. Yeah. Yeah, he's really cool.
That's cool. And with this team setup that you have, so Indra and Ashura, they're also brand new to Storm Connections, right? But together they have a combination secret technique,
I'm glad you asked me about this. Yes, they do. I think the secret techniques in this game, okay, I'm just letting it talk. It can speak for itself. Get them up, get them down.
Family's linking up.
Sheesh.
Oh. It's
they combine both for no reason. No,
everything.
Nobody in the series lives after this. Like nobody lives. It's crazy. I love it. I think it takes a lot of the over the top jutsus and just kind of like it fits so well.
It combines all of those.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a massive attack. I think it's crazy to see all of his different movesets. How he kind of plays in his awakening mode, and then also with that combination secret technique, like especially finishing on that.
Yeah.
It'd be
chef's kiss. Nah, that's great.
Very
one of my favorite things for sure about this character. And I always get surprised with like when you guys add like the team ultimates. Every time it's literally a movie.
I know.
Every single time. It's so sick. Oh my gosh.
the family that slays together, I guess, right?
Yeah. I want to know the enemy. Like, who would they do that on? Like, who makes that necessary?
Who deserves that?
Who deserves that? Yeah.
Whoever you're playing against, I guess.
Yeah, but that's pretty cool. That's the bare minimum. What makes this character really good? Even tag in like pills as well, or what do you call it? The attack up option. Mm-hmm. So like I said, every combo has that option to stun. So you can just, you know, pop that, continue in, go in, do this. There's so much you can do with this character. It's insane.
Do you think he has good aerial combos too?
Yeah. I would say like I said, like if you don't know how this character is, you're gonna think this last attack in this combo does too much damage because it does a lot of noise. It's very big. I think this is the flashiest finale from an aerial combo. So I feel like if you don't have the experience, his aerial combos a lot is going to bait a lot of newer player subs, like to make them sub that. Mm-hmm. Besides, I think you can continue it too. Let me check. Yeah, you can continue it. I don't know if you can continue off the ground.
I think you can.
Yeah, you can. You can.
Oh, yes.
So he can do what everybody else can do, along with making it feel like it does a lot more damage than it's supposed to. So yeah, I would say his aerial combo is like up there with some of the best of them, for sure.
Okay. And using him as an assist, because we're kind of seeing him as the main character right now, right?
Yeah.
How does he perform as like an assist character?
Really well. So let me see if I can, I don't know if I can time this right, where I get them to jump. Maybe even do this. Nah, I kind of want them to just do what I want. Okay, it doesn't matter. But basically, yeah, as an assist, I could still use that off of basically like my own stuns that this character has in the middle of his combos. There's just a lot I could do to add it in to even set up like an ultimate if I'm in that scenario. When I get it back, I'll show you. But yeah, he's very strong assist. He'll hit all, like let's say if the opponent I'm fighting uses their assist as well too, and I use it at the right time, it can hit all the assists and knock them out. I think you have to spin at least two or three subs to avoid his assist jutsu.
The whole range of it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
You have to use at least two or three subs to avoid the like how many times it attacks. And yeah, it's literally up there with some of the higher tier character supports in the game. Up there with Ashura's, I would put it right next to it, even though Ashura, I'll put a little bit above it.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's insane. It's really good. And I think that's probably one of the most valued things this character brings, is because, you know, you're gonna switch more times than not because the options in the game.
Mm-hmm.
And you have a support that can fight as a lead and a support very well. He can do both.
Okay. Nice. Can we see that combination super technique one more time?
Yeah.
Let's see it. Let's see the family come through. He seems pretty, so he's very powerful, but like in the right hand, someone can go up against him, right?
Yes.
Like he's not undefeatable.
Yes,
he just
by no
looks
means.
Scary.
He looks scary, yeah. Like I said, a new player for sure is going to sub a lot of what he can do frame one because he's just not going to know what I can't, like what's gonna do the right damage based off of the effects it's giving.
Yeah.
So he looks very scary, but he does very average damage like everybody else.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Really good character, really good character.
I think, so we've seen Hagoromo in kind of practice mode, seeing how he plays against the CPU. But why don't we get a glimpse of how he plays against other people? So this is going to be the little grudge match between you and Glogku.
Yes.
You guys got to go into custom matchmaking and go up against each other to test out your Hagoromos, I guess, against each other.
Yep.
You're going to do this live, but he recently had a baby, so congrats, Glogku.
Yeah, big congrats.
So, Daddy Glogku and you. So, let's see kind of what's going on. You're playing as Hagoromo right now.
Yes.
You're pulling off those combos that you were showing earlier. Naruto just hit you.
There's a reason for it, but, you know, not all reasons need to be explained. Sometimes you got to donate. Every hit I've gotten so far is just my contribution, you know?
Oh, yeah. But you got a stun on Naruto. Nice. And I'm seeing the pew-pews coming out.
Yeah, like my idea was to try to pew-pew and then get something off of the stun.
Mm-hmm.
That's the one cool thing that move has. You stun after you do it, and then they can open up for a combo if you're close enough.
That was hidden, dude. That was a secret grab. No one was seeing that for sure. Okay, hold that.
What is it like playing against Glogku? Do you think you guys are pretty evenly matched?
I would say it depends on the day, honestly. Because I feel if Glogku uses his main team or I use my main team, I don't know. But if we're just picking, like, you know, characters and stuff like that, like, I think it's pretty even, honestly. Like, in this setting, I would say it's pretty even, for sure.
Like, that little nuance yeah. in this one compared to Storm 4.
Yeah, I love the amount of options they put in, and I think a lot of the options we discovered them at launch, but that Shuriken one is kind of a bit more of an advanced tech. Like a lot of knockdowns, you can actually pick up the opponent again with that.
Yeah, here I was trying so hard to bait him to sub. I mean, that's why I wasn't finishing combos. Yeah. I was praying. I was getting mad in between talking. Like, oh, so you don't want to sub? You just don't want to do it?
I guess, like, are there some advanced combos that you could do, like, if you were able to hit that sub properly?
I feel in this match, I was going for a very canon team. With the right support, there's for sure a lot of advanced things I can do to try to bait a sub, or more so to get them in like in a stun lock almost. Which I didn't really show that off because I'm pretty, I don't know how to do the stun lock, but I've seen one stun lock for this character where basically like was fighting, you can do a sequence of dashes or stopping at a certain point to make them not be able to move. So yes, there's a lot of advanced combos you can definitely do with the right setup for sure.
Counted the wrong thing, brother.
Yeah, you can't counter jutsu. You just can't counter jutsu. Okay. Now that's... Check this out.
It's fine. It's fine. You got one sub.
That's true. But I also have...
Now, in hindsight, I really wish I went Awakening with him. That would have been really cool. But I was so thirsty.
Awakening matchup? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That would have been really great. But, you know, I was so eager to donate another win, so, you know. I gotta get my good fortune in there when I can.
It's a good first showing of Algarobo.
No, good games of Glaubku, he got me there.
You take round one. I'll give it to you. That was good. Clap it up.
I'll clap it up.
I like the claps. It's good gamesmanship, you know?
Okay, see, I never take the clap in that way. Okay. Every time I get a clap at the end of the match, there's like a little Arthur meme in me where I'm bawling my fist. It's like, I don't think that's genuine. Yeah. I think you want to fight me.
Ironic clap.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, okay. No, I think the feature is really cool when I know someone wants to play me on a respectful tip, which Glaubku did. So. But anybody else on ranked, don't clap with me.
Ooh, I did like watching this match.
And so I decided to perfect Afro real quick. A man dropped his controller, but I will always say that he was trying hard. So you will not get that off of me. What a grab, dude.
Almost,
that was actually going to be good. Hi,
right,
check that out. Oh, good. Uh-huh. Nope. Oh!
I was hoping he dashed so bad there.
Oh, no, I actually like that. Oh, big attacks. See what I mean? The big attacks actually interrupting. Oh, actually, can he do this? Whoa, it can restand you.
Almost. I feel like that would have worked in like a different, like not from the air.
Oh, gotcha. But it is the down combo. The down combo does leave him airborne, so in a way, I don't think I have a lot of options. Ooh. Beautiful. All right, please.
Almost out of reach.
Did you grab?
I did grab, but it was just like one little frame.
There's
shot
a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah,
the
I was gonna mention that's what I'm talking about. Like when he gets in momentum, the things that he throws on the screen in the right positioning is just you just really have to pay attention. Like, look at how much of the screen that electricity took up. It's ridiculous.
And it's a good way to catch the assist, right? Yeah. Like, once those assists come in, then drop that lightning, and there's no chance.
I don't know what I'm going to do. That's the problem.
I think if that happens, you need to add another L to your channel name. You need to become Afro Senju LL, right? I don't know who gave you the first L, but I'm going to give you the second.
The trash talk is crazy.
Oh my god. Oh, Kaguya! Hi.
And you got the hidden grab right there.
Snug it in there. Ooh. Yep.
I'm seeing now.
Or he did.
He's snug it in
he
there.
Got
yeah.
the hidden grab.
That's what I mean. Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, lightning still comes out, but you got out of it. Wow, the black hole.
But I think that's a good example of like how you can make a lot of stuff happen on screen so that you can't see that grab coming.
No, big attacks, please. Big attacks, please. Oh my god.
The lightning takes up. So it's crazy. That's a really strong user.
I'm still out of subs here. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. Did I choose the wrong? Yeah, I chose the wrong assist.
You got some lightning, too.
A little bit.
A little tiny bit. Not the same amount of lightning.
Yeah, he can hit me with as much as he wants.
Hold on.
As the main.
Yo, no, stop.
No. You got it.
That's all I asked for.
Hey.
I'm not a greedy person. I just want to one.
Nice.
That's
crazy. The channel name is safe. I mean, but now that you got one, right?
You can really see this difference in speed too, right here. Like Hagoromo, the way he moves versus Madara.
Yeah, that first hit, man.
Yo,
check out this combo.
Uh-huh. Okay, I'm done checking it out. Please put it down, bro. No more. I don't want the subscription service.
Oh, yes. Oh, thanks for giving that to me. Oh, what do you mean? Wait. No, backhits. Backhits, no.
Agia, you couldn't just turn around. We couldn't just get a little ricochet action?
Uh-huh. Hold that.
I have no choice.
No, sir. No, sir. Really we're doing an ultimate.
Okay, I had no subs. I'd take that.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you called the assist. I wasn't going to risk it. What I really like about this ultimate is the activation is a projectile.
Would you have been able to sub out of that?
No. Yeah, he got me just right in the middle of his hits. Any hit, you can just combo cancel off. It's the same.
If I have ult, like, that's one of my go-to options for sure. All right.
Oh, the ball out, yeah.
Yeah, hold the crap.
Ooh, oh, that was really good. Hey, that was a good combination.
Yeah.
Can I come back here?
No.
That is a question.
No. No, this is mine. This is mine. Green bar. You're not even seeing the yellow.
Gotta make this comeback. I don't remember what happened here.
Oh, actually,
we're gonna see.
Yellow. Now, why did I talk, man? It feels like you get a power boost whenever I trash talk. It's crazy.
Hold on, bro. Maybe this might be the craziest comeback of all time.
Oh! Yes! Into Ashura! Ooh. Get him! Twice!
Oh, yeah.
Bro.
Yeah. Ooh. I've seen this movie before.
Oh, without subs and being aggressive.
Okay, I'll give the credit where it's due. You're going
it's crazy. Tough. So that's two Club Crew. Well, technically it's one because the last one was a donation. I just got to set the zone. Okay, this is the official one. I think he got this one. I see.
You can tell when I'm like donating and actually giving a match based off of my tone. The affliction was a little quieter in the beginning half because I'm starting very like on my Christian tip. In the second half, it's more like aggressive because like now I'm mad, you know?
Yeah.
So he got me. He got me that one. I'll give him that.
Okay, got it.
I'll clap for that.
All right, we got you back on Hagoromo.
Okay, so I'm not gonna make it easy on you.
So at this point, I downloaded a DLC called Aggression, so this is a different match. This is a different me.
Okay. You got the Aggression boost right
yes.
there?
Yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Fist or ball?
I'm seeing it. Getting in there.
Ooh. Lightning? Yeah, have you heard of this? Whatever that was that lightning called? Yamato Hakushin. What?
The substitution recharge on this too is like it kind of makes you play a little bit differently than in past Storm games, right?
Yeah. The Japanese dub. I think it's very fast paced in regards to in past Storm games. I feel like you need to take time to charge and maybe give mutual respect if you both are empty on that. But this one is you just have you can keep on going.
Yeah. Oh, we got you in awakening mode now.
Yeah, this is that aggression thing I was talking about. Mm-hmm. I was very mad.
You're bringing out all the elements.
Literally everything.
He has the sword too. Oh my goodness.
Literally everything.
Oh, I'm a pixel away. I'm a pixel away. Hagoromo, please. No.
That grab is like.
It's great. It's amazing. It's amazing.
You really have to be watching out for it.
Okay. Now I'm gonna have to try hard. Damn.
With that awakening mode, it looks like it looks like you got to play more aggressively when you're playing as him, right?
Yes.
In that awakening mode.
I'll say so. I feel like I had more actions, like with all the D-pad actions. In that case, I just did them all. But if I was doing it on a more like not talking so aggressively playing tip, you know, I could block do it or hit him and stun him and do it. Like a lot more opportunity to damage him for sure.
Mm-hmm. Can I get a balloon? All right, too late.
Oh. What hit me? Wait, what you got there? Dirty tricks? Just
little, and his normal attacks don't worry about it. Into the grab. Like, his normal attacks seem to have, like, a really wide range, so you can just interrupt, like, anything, pretty much.
Yeah. You see how, like, from the air, brought him down? Yeah, it's crazy.
Oh my god. You re-stood me. You re-stood me there.
Yeah. I gotta get my mom in there a little bit. Hold on. Mom? Mom? Oh, she's gone. My ex is gone.
Let's go, Pain. Let's go, Pain. And lightning. No lightning? Okay. Oh!
Oh my god. No lightning.
You had a sub. What happened? Light. You had a sub. Come on.
I don't know. I just don't know, bro. My sub didn't like me. Hagi took it. Hagi, please.
Okay.
Where did she just go?
What a grab.
You see her run in the back after I did this? Why would she leave me?
I almighty pushed her away. You know?
I guess so. Obito?
I think.
Oh,
okay.
And it hits
the
support.
The
juice is just too strong.
Yeah. That's good. That's good. And big dash, too. Uh-huh. Okay.
Are we told?
It's a good way to keep him, at bay, so you can get that space to come back in and hit him with your normal combos.
Yeah.
Oh.
Do something.
Bonk. Okay, right. We'll take that. Uh-huh. Into.
Oh, still got clip. Oh my gosh. Seeing the jutsu in action is just way better than I could even explain it. Getting clipped by the little hair of it.
Let's
it's so good.
Oh, how could I almost assist, baby?
Oh my goodness.
Ooh. We're still in this.
Gotta save this sub.
Oh, got the stun. Okay. But you were able to. That was your jutsu, right?
Yes.
Lightning. You were able to get out of that.
And now you got subs back. That's crazy. You got sub advantage now. Oh, I parried. No. Oh, good try.
Let's
go.
Oh man. If I subbed like when I won, it would have been over.
The range on that grab is like pretty intense, right?
Yeah,
I think like the way you edit that, like you pretty much got him with that grab. But there's a couple of like good combos that you can set up with his grab, you know, like to initiate a good combo.
I would say a lot of his combos and very like the stun that it gives. It ends very quick for that grab to go out because it's slow. But the best time you could use that grab, it adds a lot of pressure when they have no subs, so you can get them to move in a certain way and clip them with the support. Or if you have certain supports that keep them still, like I was saying, like I think Rock Lee, Neji, there's so many supports that can just hold you there.
Yeah,
that's like a perfect like combination with how his grab works.
Okay.
Unless you're up close. He does have a slow startup, but if you're up close, it still can clip you pretty fast.
If you're up close, would it grab right away? Or does it have
to? It still has a little delay, but it'll grab pretty, yeah, more or less, pretty close like what an average grab would do.
We got multiple.
Okay.
All right, let me come.
Pew, pew, pew.
Now we got.
Oh, it's no combos, damn. Oh, good guard break. Hey, thank you. Hey, surf's up. Okay, nice. No, surf's not.
Nope, sorry. It's ball gang, bro.
Oh, ooh.
Ball gang.
I'm just rooting for whoever you're playing as.
Thank you. I'm looking at past me with I don't know. Is it anger? I want him to do more.
How's it? Yeah. How does it feel watching past Afro playing?
I was doing this hidden technique I didn't know I had in me. It's called mashing, where I just press circle without the thought of why I'm pressing it. I just want to have a conversation with myself. Like, what are we doing here? What's the objective?
Yeah.
Are we flexing our finger muscle? But no, I'm holding my own,
Yeah, you're hanging in there. I think, like you said, when you're playing against Hagoromo, it's a little bit, like, he has a way of, like, kind of keeping you scared because there's a lot of things going on.
Yeah.
Like, he's got the pew-pews going on, and, like, at one point, Globe Crew is kind of spamming them, right?
Yeah.
Oh, not the lightning!
We need that lightning.
Caught him too, man. Ish! Okay, no subs. Do your worst. Surf's up, baby.
Please.
Surf's not up. Surf's big never ball. Up.
Oh, you barely missed it.
Oh, sick cancel, dude. Oh, I have to sub it now. That's crazy.
Andra.
I think, like, one cool thing about this game, you could be on that one pixel and, like, turn the entire fight around.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Mm-hmm. The amount of times I've seen that one pixel in this game has been impressive. And the amount of times I've seen someone come back on like spiritual health is also crazy.
Surf's finally up, man. Damn. It's been a while.
Oh my god.
The jutsu. Every time I see it, I just gotta pay homage. It lingers. He's the best.
No, sir.
He's got all the elements at his disposal.
Okay. He does.
Ooh, you got the little poison on him.
Oh,
nice.
I tried dodging it, but that caught the assist too, man. The power of that assist is crazy. Oh, into the sky. Here we go.
Okay.
Man doesn't want to sub it, so it's okay. Ooh, sub into guard break? That's crazy. Oh, back hits! I'll take that. And then it's time for the pew-pew-pew. Pew-pew-pew. It's time for the pew-pew-pew.
I do gotta hold it.
Uh-huh. Time for the pew-pew-pew. Pew-pew-pew. Pew-pew-pew-pew-pew.
Oh, man. I just gotta hold it.
Oh,
Jigen's assist and.
Do we finish this? Do we finish this? Do we finish this? No!
I was praying for a sub watching his back. It hurt just the same. Like, surely 1 second, I'm going to get that sub back and I'm gonna give it back to him.
There. Yeah.
That was good. That's a really good team he uses as well, too. However,
I can't beat you in this next one. It'll be interesting to see what kind of teams people set up with the Hagoromo.
Yes.
Here's the thing, Afro. It's 2 months after the game's release, and this was the only time that I was ever going to challenge you for a rematch. Because I got a kid coming on soon, you know, and when that kid comes out, I have no idea how much time I'm going to have to practice this. So the next time I'll challenge you is when you have a baby, okay?
Lobku says that, but then he posted five videos after the kid. It was impressive. I don't know how he did it.
He's just got him in his back pocket.
Yeah, he was ready.
Connection 7, or Naruto Storm 7, and we'll get our rematch.
Okay.
Watch, I'm gonna have a child.
Oh, right. Boy. So, because I'm having a kid soon, I decided to play Team Old Man right here.
It fits. I get it. I see it.
Okay. Finally have a third old man to put on my team.
Grab.
Mifune is really cool too. I'm surprised I don't see him play a lot more in online.
I love Mifune so much. I mained Mifune back on Storm 4. He's a bit different now.
Yeah,
there's the guy. That's the sub bait I was looking for. Onoki, on the other hand, I don't have a lot of experience with, but so far he has a cool assist. You have to sub that.
That's nice. That like delayed hit on the jutsu with the lightning. So even if you got your hit got interrupted, but you're able to
it still goes off. Yeah. The animation the Hagoromo like does before. I feel like if you interrupt him at a certain point, the lightning doesn't go off, but most people do not hit that moment.
Yeah.
So it's I can only say it's so good so many times because it's just amazing, bro. I love it. I love it. I can keep on saying it, to be honest.
Okay. Okay, where are we going?
I'm gonna counter. I'm calling it right now. Countering.
Okay.
All right, I thought you were
gonna
dash.
Good counter.
Thought about it. Good counter. Yo, we can fight after this game if you want. I'm ready. We can do whatever.
Are you, I feel like you're not suggesting a Naruto fight anymore. You're suggesting another kind of fight. Maybe with real fists? I don't know. That helped.
Yeah, one thing I didn't mention, but I did it prior, is both of his jutsus also can be done in the air. So with the pew-pews and the lightning.
Yeah.
And that goes for subs as well.
I thought I felt a little violence in the tone. Okay. Whoa. Uh-huh.
Yo, Sasuke, please.
No, we jumped those. What just happened? What, did you just delete my assist? Right. Is that fair?
I like the homing of it, too. The homing pew-pews.
Yeah, it's really good. It curves at certain angles you wouldn't even think it would try to reach.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Do it! Whoa, what a sub! What a sub, dude! Into ultimate! Oh, there you go, man. The step back into ultimate to deny my assist. I call Onoki right there.
He's gonna kill. Yeah, let's go. I love this.
That was. That's a fantastic win.
Yeah. That was a good ending.
Yeah. The most satisfying. You get the anime finish scene. I feel like I won. All of it.
This is why you gotta donate matches in the beginning so karma comes in the end.
I see. That's a, you know, it's a karmic way of playing.
Exactly. You get it. You get
it's, it. It's playing within the span of the universe, you know? Mm-hmm. It's not just the game. It's everything coming back to you.
Okay.
So it really was a wash. GG's, bro.
The boy math makes sense, for sure. Yeah.
Boy math. Get off TikTok, Lobku. Get off TikTok right now, bro.
I'm an old man on TikTok. Anyway, pleasure playing you, man. GG's.
It was fun. GG's, brother.
Okay, well, so you got the finish. You got the finish scene. That
it's
was
the, a, it's the aggression mode.
Yeah,
know,
that was a very cinematic way to end the grudge match between you and Club Crew. And now I think, so you guys are 1-1?
Yes, 1-1 right now.
Okay.
Will it stay 1-1? I like it right here. This is good. But we're probably going to continue it because there has to be an ending to every story. So, yeah. I won't be as Christian next time. I think I'm gonna finish it off.
Okay. You know, bring out the aggro DLC. Mm-hmm. Bring it out again. But thank you for showing us the ropes with Hagoromo, showing us some of the techniques that you can use. I think it was cool to see the way you played him, and then also the way Glubku played him. There was a few different like ways that you guys both played him. You used the grab function, that little hidden grab, which is so nasty. And then the pew pews are a good way to like you know. Keep the other player at bay, but
the pressure,
keep that pressure on. Thank you to Globe Crew for joining us remotely in the future past.
How are we gonna put it?
Hagoromo's out there right now, and custom matchmaking is now available as well. So go out there, play as him, play against your other friends, get some grudge matches going on within your own kind of groups of friends. and see who comes out on top. So I hope you guys go out, enjoy custom matchmaking, enjoy Hagoromo, and you know, we'll see who's next with the season pass characters. I think there's a couple of predictions that can be made for that. I got a few.
Okay. I think my top would be, because it's something new, something that you wouldn't expect. Mitsuki's brother, legendary Seija, no, Seven Swordsman, yes. He was like one of the ones who could use all the swords. I would like to see him, that would be really cool. The new Kawaki, Boruto, I guess that's my little three. I guess put your recommendations too, what you would like to see down below as well.
Cool. And I think finally, Afro, you're gonna be, we're gonna...
Do a giveaway?
Give a little, yeah, so go to Afro Senju's channel, at Afro Senju. He's gonna be doing a giveaway for the Collector's Edition for Naruto Cross Boruto Ultimate Ninja Storm Connections. Yeah, so go out there, enjoy the game. Thank you guys for joining us, and have a very Date Bayo day.
That works, that works. Thank you for watching.
Thank you. Bye.